you come back down to the surface. I'm going through like a vortex onto a planet. It's not Earth. I left Earth a long time. It went away. But there's lots and lots of big leaves, tall trees, birds, very colourful birds. My own. I have a flowy thing on.
Like a dress?
Yeah, like a ears. I feel like I'm a fairy. I feel like I'm a fairy. I've got long hair, white hair, pointy ears, flowy dress. These funny feet. I am part of the forest. Yeah, I am the forest and the forest is me. We're the same.
But where did you come from? You just travelled through this vortex?
I was on a cloud and I zoomed away from Earth. And then this planet appeared and I had to go through like a vortex to get to it.
Okay, I understand that.
And it's beautiful. The weather's warm. There's just nature everywhere.
So how do you communicate with other beings or other fairies?
I feel like I'm a guardian of the forest. I look after it. I don't see anybody else around like me. Just the animals, birds, the trees. It's important that I walk on the earth with my bare feet, because I feel it, I hear it. It talks to me.
The earth?
Yeah. Yeah.
supposed to talk to you?
Just feelings. I can feel if something's not right. But everything's fine. Everything's all right.
So what would you do the majority of time during the day?
Walk around in the forest. Just walk around, touching the trees, feeling my feet on the earth. Being at one with everything.
And do you have to eat?
No.
What about sleep?
No. There isn't any threat to it. But I just... make sure that it's okay and that there's a connection somehow. And the forest needs me and I need the forest. We keep each other well. Joy. The trees talk to me and they're all my friends.
Can you try and explain how the trees talk to you?
Well, I suppose a better word would be commune. We just commune together. We're just one. Belong together. It's just a sense of belonging and completeness.
Are there any other beings on this planet?
I can't see any. But I think there are. Different areas, but we don't. We're quite isolated in that we have our territory, if you like, to look after, to commune with. That's it, really.
Okay. I'd like the fairy to leave the scene, float away from that scene, and move forward to another important day. A day that you consider to be important when something is happening. We have now moved forward to an important day. What is happening and what do you see?
I do actually have wings, and we've been caught together. This big crystal building. There's lots of us there. There's a activity and something's exciting or something's happening. We're all in this, all about the guardians, we're guardians of nature, and we're in this place. Oh, the earth, the nature and the earth needs help. We need to help.
So what are they asking? How can you help?
To go there. To go there and help. Help Mother Nature. Help her. And the animals. And the forests.
And how does everyone feel about that?
It will be sad to leave there, but it's help is needed. So where we go and we help.
Then tell me about this crystal place that you've gathered in.
Like a crystal building, like a dome, and we're inside the dome. It's light, it's crystallized lights, all different lights.
Is it polished crystal or is it natural peaked crystals, formation crystals? So who is asking you in this gathering to go and help Earth?
There's a very tall being. He's in charge of like something. But he's asking if we can go and help.
And is it just fairies in this place where you've gathered?
Yeah.
How many?
Loads. Loads. Male and female. Probably not really male and female, but there is male and female.
And do you have a family?
No. Well, they are my family. We're all one. We're all connected.
So what happens next then? What does all the other fairies say?
Some go, some don't. Some's too hard. Some couldn't do it.
So how do you sign up to go then? Once you What's the process?
I think you just go over and say you go.
Is he wearing anything?
Robes. Long robe. White. Tall. Looks like a bit like a very old, tall, wise wizard.
Can you see her face?
Yeah, it's got a white hair. Beard. Pointy ears. Large, light blue eyes. Quite humanoid, really.
Okay. And how do you speak to him and other fairies? Do you have a language?
We just know what each other are thinking. We're linked.
And do you have names?
Regions, not names.
So depending on where you're from a region?
Mm-hmm. That we are a guardian of that region. Because it actually is not just there, where we go lots of places. Always, but always linked to the nature of the planet. We communicate with the nature of the planets. And we make sure that everything's okay.
So tell me a bit more about your planet. Do you have rain?
I actually don't know whether I have a planet. I have a purpose, and my purpose is nature. And my home is with nature, and I go to where nature needs me.
So you move around a lot?
Yes. Yes, I do. And just commune with nature and heal nature and touch nature.
I was just thinking, if you're in nature and you have lots of trees around, trees need water. Or doesn't this planet, or where you are now?
It has water, yeah, okay. It has water. It does rain. But it rains a set time each day. And that's it.
So let's move forward a bit then. You said you signed up. What happens next?
I have to go there then. I have to go to the earth to help nature there.
Okay, so they've agreed everything then?
Yes. Yeah, I said I would go. People who have said yes, who volunteered, are taken and we go.
Okay. So let's move forward to a time now where you've received all the instructions that you need and the processes of what will happen and how it will happen. We've moved to that time and we're there now. Can you tell me what the processes and instructions are to how you will be incarnating into Earth? Do you choose families?
We do choose families. We choose the right families for enough freedom to be able to be with nature.
And how long does this process take?
There are several different lives. And I can go in all of them. But there's not many. I'm aware of this one. I'm aware of another one.
Another life?
Yeah, but that's it. Just that one. So two in different time frames. And the other one, I live in the woods, outside of a little village. And I am the healer, the wise woman. Uses nature to make things and to help heal people.
Okay, so there's seven lives and seven time frames, but you are aware of two.
Just two.
And when is this time frame then, the first one from the woods?
14.
And then your current one now.
Yeah. I don't think there are any others. Just those two.
Okay.
There's a future one. There's a future one.
Do you have information on the future life?
To do with the earth in the future.
Is all going to plan?
Yes.
does it seem like everyone is helping the Earth?
Yes. The Earth is different though, it's lighter. It's not as heavy and dense.
So when you go into your future life, what would that purpose be then?
Same. Nature, looking after the animals, making sure nature's okay. Taking care.
So when you choose your family to come into a life, in the planning stages, do you do that by yourself or do you have a team that helps you?
There are people that help. And it's discussed what would be the best choice. To enable me to do what I need to do.
And have you been to Earth before?
No.
So is there any other training that you need to go through before incarnating on Earth?
I can't see any. Just picking. Best life to enable me to do what I need to do.
And where does this take place? In the same crystal building or do you have to go somewhere else?
This was after we went. This is after we went. On the ship.
So you had to go on a ship?
Well, I suppose a ship would be the best way to explain it, but it's more like travelling through vortexes on a train. That's what it's more like. The way we travel is through vortexes of light on a train.
Okay.
And that's how we do it.
So say you are now ready to incarnate on Earth. How do you leave the place where you're at, like the ship? How does that process work from going to the ship into a baby or an embryo, depending on what stage you come into the physical? How does that process work?
Again, I see it as like a vortex, a tunnel of light that goes down into the mother that I go down into.
Okay. And what happens to the fairy body then, the physical body of the fairy?
It's still here. It's inside this body.
Okay. Now let's leave that scene. Let's leave that scene and move away. And move into the time frames you explained. Let's move into the person who lives in the woods in a village as a healer and a wise woman. We've now moved into the first time frame of the lady in the woods in a village. She's a healer and a wise woman. You're there now. Tell me what you were doing. And take your time to orientate yourself in the scene.
My name is Elsa. And I collect herbs. I go out, some have to be collected by the full moon, some collected by the crescent moon and the new moon, all depending on when you collect the herbs as to what they're used for. I live outside the village because I'm not really accepted. They come to me, women who are pregnant, people who are ill, but I don't live with them. I need to be on my own in nature. Of the woods come to see me.
And how do you help the planet and the earth by living in the woods at this time?
By being there. My energy communes with the forest and gives the forest life. Healing and love.
And you said you're a healer. Do you heal using herbs?
Yes.
So what types of healings would you do?
Oh, those. Helping women, pregnant women, have a nice birth. Wounds. Toothache. All sorts.
And tell me a bit about yourself. How do you look like? What are you wearing?
I'm wearing a long tunic thing. I'm quite small, petite. Long dark hair. I'm quite elusive though. Disappear into the forest and reappear at will. It's strange. think the cottage is like a base where I make my herbs and my concoctions. But I live very much out in the forest as well.
That would make sense. You being so connected with the earth. So is that how you spend the majority of your day?
Yes, that is.
And do you grow things yourself?
No, I don't. Well, I suppose I visualize the growing of the plant, and the plant grows. But it's all very natural. I don't. Nature will provide what I visualize, what I need. She takes care of me and I take care of her. We are together, we're one.
And do you feel old? Or young?
I would say 30s, 40s. Not really old. I get attacked by dogs and die, though, in the forest. Men with dogs.
Do you know why that happened?
They set the dogs on me. Which? Not which.
Is there anything in particular that you did that caused that to happen?
No, I communed with nature. I dealt with herbs. That was it.
Okay, so let's move forward. Let's move forward to the last day of your life when you get attacked by the dogs. And whatever has happened has already happened. You leave that body. And you're now on the other side of it. What happens when you leave the body? What do you sense or feel?
I feel as though that part of me then joins
Now let's leave that woman behind to where she belongs, and I'm going to ask if I may speak to Tracy's subconscious.